Sometimes we don't take enough time to analyze the thoughts of our hearts. What actually is that war in us? What's the cause of war in me? What's it? Something that we need to do, something that we should have got to do. What's it? So I have five things there. Is there a fight in you about something? Can you bring to the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ? And your wife is saying, don't fight like that. It's not me. No, I want to fight. I want you. I want the passion of you. What's it that's fighting? Can we lay to rest on Jesus, who took so much of fight on the cross and he died? They were not his fights, they were ours. Can you bring this fight to me, to me? What is it that's fighting me? Lord Jesus, we want to bring every fight in his hands on the cross. We want your peace to be with us. We remember the blood of Jesus Christ, which made peace for us. All fights go out of us. And you must cross like a shield of faith. Stop the bars. Others accusing us, us accusing us, fights. Then comes the fight. Is there anything you are running away from? Or something that you are hastening to fast? It means you run for recognition. Recognition, approval, fame. You run for flat. Things attract people from front. Things chase people from behind. This happened to Cain. He began to flee when no man pursues. And the father said to Cain, why are you like a fugitive? Who is chasing you? Why do you flee? What's that chasing you? Why have you become a fugitive? And why have you become a woman? Are you away? You're fleeing. Shall we put that to rest now? Father, we want to put to rest things that cause us to run away, make excuses. We want to rest you. Thank you. Thank you. Now fight. Now fight. And thirdly, more fight. Things that bring favors. God is this, God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of love and of love and song. Some fears are reasonable. Fear begins reasonable. Very soon, it becomes unreasonable. Same with worry. You begin to worry about something reasonable. Then it grows till it becomes. Can we pass this fear? God is as we pass this fear. Things that makes us get your cold sweat and we wake up in the night. Ask me to speak to something. wait. We wait. Wait. Jesus said, come unto me, that I be weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. It may be way too hard to bear, but Jesus wants to be his shepherd. I have many ways to get it. And when I get heavy laden, I see the Lord appear. He comes to me. And he tells me, this is the way the master meant, should not the servant tread in still. This is the way the master meant, should not the servant tread in still. Thank you, Jesus. And I give ways that you may not even understand. When the British Prime Minister went on, so was it for us. Threatening our country and our side. I think this is a great revelation. So I took it to God and I took it to the world. I thought if he truly had the welfare of Sri Lanka in his heart, is offering a solution. He will deal with the problem in a more mature way. So we are left with the problem of an agreed president. And we have to take it to the Lord in prayer. And I know Lord is very able to shoulder that burden also. You might remember when we had the services at Gay College, just that week, a friend of ours had died at Kerala, at the Grigasya, because of the suicide bomb. He was a father, he was smashed to pieces. His brother was a doctor, and his family went to Europe for a long, long time. And personally came close to us that Sunday when we had the service at Gary College, we to see that. And at the intercession time, two doves came and rested on the altar. How many of you were there that day? And we were surprised, everybody clapped. And there were no suicide bombs on the roads of Colombo after that. Of course, many prayed. Yes, let's give a hand clap for them. So that the nation's earth and sustains the earth. There's a house of God that does not go to sleep. So we have appointed this morning prayer time of a single congregation. We'll do at 9:30. Evening prayer time at 6:30. We have two friends who have come from Germany, Siegfried and Haley. They are very senior ministers in Germany. They are very tender and kind. He has traveled to many parts of Germany and since we have met him many, many times. Now he is with Pastor Greg Scott congregation in Bielefeld, but we met him even before that. So he has come at a very opportune season. His apartment is in our welcome center. He's made a time with him. Come and meet them. They have come to feel together. How many of you remember this and that? Quite like that at this position. So already quite a few have known each other with them. Please make a time and come and see them. Also, I will pray some way that they'll be there for the 6:30 prayer time. And may I ask the nation to make up a list for the 6:30 prayer time? Maybe today you can give your name. Some may say Monday, for 1 hour I'll come. we will ensure that someone is there. I think we will have it as support there, easy to handle that. We want to make sure this follows. Nothing goes wrong in school. Nothing goes wrong in school. And for us, Chotel was celebrating House of God, House of God's mercy. That's what Chotel is doing. Celebrating House of God's mercy. You can call this House of God's Majesty. You can call it House of God's Magnificence. You know, I like words. So we want to ensure that all this has gone on doesn't have a backlash. Jesus Christ is able to take every nation into his bosom, instruct the head of the head of state through our prayers, through our prophecies, through our intercession. We can do it. We'll say that we can do it. I'm sure many of you are feeling exhausted. What after this? Big expenditure. What will be the budget like? Who is going to bear this expenditure? What after this? We can rest it in the bosom of Jesus. He's a sufficient Savior for individuals. And let our failures not pursue us, sins and temptations, evil injustice. Out there, hurt and betrayals inside. Will you please place your hands on your heart? Any hurt, any betrayal. Betrayal goes to very deep, very deep, very deep. We are designed for fidelity, just the way fidelity is very deep. Betrayal really goes to many layers of our heart. If there's any sense of such in you, only Jesus can give you betrayal. Hear me, please. Medicine can't, counselors can't, psychology can't. Betrayal is to be. Only Christ is to be. Lord Jesus, please hear me. Lord Jesus, please hear me. Lord Jesus, please hear me. Every person that has gone deep, you are such a leader. Thank you. Thank you. Hurts that brought humiliation and shame, we constantly, we see Jesus. At the right hand of the throne, he who was crucified suffered shame. And Roshan spoke of the tower. And you know that tower, why can't the face of Jesus? Some people think it's still preserved. I don't know the veracity of it, but we know there is a tower there, why can't the face of Jesus? Then comes fear, then people say, I hate these things that come at me. Will you take it to Jesus? I hate these things that come at me. You may know someone who says, I hate the things that came at me. Shall I take it to Jesus? You will bring someone you know who carries this kind of hate in their heart. Their life has been so unfair. He is a sufficient Savior. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you. Now the solution. We have looked at the problem enough. Let's go to the solution. God judged all evil on Calvary. On the cross, Jesus faced all evil. Wages of sin was death.